नमस्कार दोस्तों, देश की बात में आप सबका स्वागत है। दोस्तों, आरबीआई और इंडियन गवर्नमेंट के बीच में टसल चल रहा है, जिससे कहा जा रहा है कि आरबीआई की ऑटोनॉमी को खतरा है। और इस विषय पर ज़्यादा जानकारी के लिए मैंने बात करी संतोष मेहरोत्रा जी से, जो कि देश के जाने माने इकोनॉमिस्ट हैं।
वेलकम यू सर ऑन देश की बात। सर माय क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई सो मच टसल बिटवीन द आरबीआई एंड इंडियन गवर्नमेंट? वी हैव सीन ड्यूरिंग द राजन एरा आल्सो, व्हाई इट इज हैपनिंग?
इंटरनेशनल वर्ल्ड, द सेंट्रल बैंक ऑफ अ कंट्री इज यूजुअली क्वाइट इंडिपेंडेंट एंड ऑफ द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द यूनियन गवर्नमेंट। नाउ व्हिच इज द ट्रेडिशन दैट वी हैव बीन अटेम्प्टिंग टू बिल्ड इन आवर कंट्री for the last several years as well, an effort which was reinforced by the creation of the Monetary Policy Committee. And it's very important that the Reserve Bank of India is able to maintain its autonomy and independence and has have an ability to actually supervise the scheduled banks, particularly the public sector banks, in ways that it sees fit. Unfortunately, in the past, we have seen when governments, elected governments in particular, act in the interest of some businessmen, this has been seen as creating difficulties for the financial sector. And this is part of the reason why, the banking sector is suffering from NPAs. Therefore, this tussle in some ways is something age-old that happens around the world, and we are seeing that happening here. And it's critical that these issues are brought out into the open so that, economists can comment on this situation, because it's absolutely critical that there is a balance maintained between autonomy on the one hand of the central bank and the responsibilities that a central government faces public, and this becomes the source of instability, which is perceived internationally to be creating instability for the domestic economy, for the national economy.
Because sir, is it wrong for long term that this has been seen the first time that India is facing such a crisis between the central bank and government, because especially in under the Modi regime?
Well, you see, the point is that this might be the first time that it has come out into the open, but we all know perfectly well that even at the time of the demonetization, it's almost certain that the central bank could not have been happy about that decision. I mean, it was a decision that was in some ways, they had to accept at the last minute. And we've had periods of tension between the previous government and the finance ministry as well, not just this government. But you arrived in saying that it is for the first time that we are seeing that this row is coming out into the open. And, in some ways it is good for our democracy. Let me explain why. Let us recall that in the last several years, this twin balance sheet problem, in other words, the companies not being able to generate enough revenues of their own and not being able to repay debts that they've taken from banks, and which has adversely, severely affected the bank's own balance sheet. So the twin balance sheet problem has led to a dramatic decline in investment rates in the economy. And it's critical that these issues are resolved out in the open in a democracy, because the more it is that these things come out into the open, the more the real issues become open to discussion and debate among economists.
Yeah,
among economists, and therefore it's a very good thing that this is happening.
Thank you, Santosh Mehrotra. Santosh Mehrotra is saying it's a good thing so that the issues can be discussed in open platforms. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Bye-bye.